current electricity. So what is current? And when does current flow through a conductor? If you take a normal copper wire lying on a table, a piece of a copper wire, and touch this copper wire, you will not find any kind of current. कोई झटके वटके देता नहीं. लेकिन जब आप इसे एक EMF source से connect कर देते हो, once you connect to a potential difference source, current flows through it. We will come to this point later कि why does current flows through a conductor when it is connected across two points having potential difference. Before that, let's quickly brief out what is electric potential. We know that electric potential at a point is the measure of electric potential energy of that point. So if we have two point A and B, it has got its own potential VA, this has got potential VB. So if you want to find potential difference, then potential difference between VA and B, you can write work done in moving a charge from A to B, and that is to a unit test charge. So how do we define work done in moving a unit test charge from point A to the point B in electrostatic field? If we look at SI unit of the work done is joule and charge is coulomb. So this comes out to be volt. You can also define 1 volt is equal to 1 joule over 1 coulomb. In general, potential difference V is work done over Q. So work done is also equal to QV. So whenever any charge is placed in a region or in between two points where potential difference exists, this potential does work. Now two terms more. Number one is EMF, electromotive force. Electromotive force. EMF ka abbreviation hai electromotive force. It has nothing to do with this, in fact, except electrons are force which is motivating electron. But in fact, EMF is a potential difference between two points with its maximum value. What is EMF? I repeat it again. It is maximum value of the potential difference between two points. Look at this video. In this video, I am showing you a cell, and it is marked with 1.5 volt. If you go in the market and buy any cell or battery, you will find it is always marked with some value like 6 volt or 1.5 volt. The value which is marked on this device, cell or battery, it is termed as EMF, or it indicates EMF of that source. And normally, when you connect this EMF source to any electric circuit, you never get this much as output. If you are connecting 6 volt battery, you will never get a 6 volt at output. It will always be a less. So there are two terms, maximum potential difference, that is called EMF, and another is normal term, that is called potential difference. Scientifically, we can also define EMF as maximum potential difference in across the source when circuit is open. Now you must have in your mind, what is this concept open circuit and closed circuit? Open circuit means when current is drawn by the circuit. Current is drawn in the circuit. The circuit is said to be, the circuit is called open circuit. What is then closed circuit? When current is drawn in the circuit, or current flows in the circuit is called closed circuit. Then what is basic difference between open and closed circuit? How do we recognize practically whether circuit is open or closed? I can give you a very simple example. In a room wherever you are sitting, if you switch off all the switches which are connected with different electrical devices, maybe your AC, maybe geyser, maybe with fan, maybe with light, if you switch off everything, then in that particular room circuit is off, circuit is open. And when you switch on everything, or even a one device, suppose you have switched on tube light inside your room, circuit becomes closed. Another circuit from the circuit diagram you can understand. This is the resistance connected across an EMF source with battery or cell. This is key. If this key is open, then no current will flow through it. Circuit is open. When you plug in key here, current begins to flow through it. This is termed as closed circuit. So, what actually do we need? We need a potential difference to make a current to flow through the circuit, because current flows only in closed circuit. In open circuit, there is no flow of current. Let's see now what is current, basic understanding of current. It is defined as the rate of flow of electric charge per second through a conductor. So if Q amount of charge passes through a conductor, in time t, then current I is equal to Q over t. So SI unit will be 1 coulomb over 1 second. That is said to be 1 ampere. Now 1 ampere current, numerically if you see in this formula, it is equal to 1 coulomb over 1 second. Practically this definition seems incorrect. Numerically you can say a current flowing through a conductor is said to be 1 ampere. I repeat, current flowing through the conductor is said to be 1 ampere when 1 coulomb charge passes through a conductor in 1 second. But remember, 1 coulomb charge is pretty large amount of charge. However, 1 ampere current is practically not that much. So numerically is okay, mathematical version, but otherwise this definition cannot be accepted. So 1 ampere, or a definition I am writing, a current flowing through a conductor is said to be 1 ampere when 1 coulomb charge, 1 coulomb of charge passes through a conductor in 1 second. Why do I say that this definition is not experimentally very obvious? So just check it out, because let's assume example. Suppose 1 coulomb of charge flows through a conductor in 1 second. Then let's count how many electrons flow, So there is a principle called quantization of charge, and according to quantization of charge, Q is equal to plus minus Ne, N is the number of electron, E is the charge of an electron. When you put this 1, so you can get Ne is 1.6 10 raised to the power minus 19 coulomb. So N is equal to 1 over 1.6 into 10 raised to the power. So this comes out 6.25 into 10 raised to the power 18 electrons. This number is pretty high. That's why this definition doesn't sound good experimentally. For that you will see in further coming time that different definitions which is experimentally true. But anyway, number one, and current is a scalar quantity. Number two, conventionally, current always flows from positive terminal towards negative terminal. Positive terminal is assumed to have positive potential, and many people think that negative terminal means it carries negative potential. Answer is no. Positive terminal and negative terminal is basically a comparative study. Comparative means positive terminal shows this point has higher potential than other point. Negative potential is a lower potential point. For example, if we have two point A and B, potential of point A is 10 volt and potential of point B is plus 5 volt, still point B will act as negative terminal with respect to the point A, and you connect any wire in between these two, the current begins to flow, right? So I repeat, conventionally current always flows from higher potential to lower potential, and positive and negative terminal does not practically mean that one has negative potential and another has positive potential. Now, another question will come in your mind. Why does current flow from positive to negative terminal? I mean from positive potential to lower potential. It is a nature, rule of nature, because we know that in order to make a flow of current through any conductor, it is essential to apply potential difference across it. I mean to say two ends of the wire must be kept and connected, one at higher potential, another at lower potential. Then energy begins to flow, electrical energy begins to flow, right? From positive potential to negative potential, and in nature, energy always flows from higher to lower level. Let's take another analog example. We have two vessels filled with the water. One is big vessel, another is kept on the same level. This is a small vessel filled with water. Now you connect these two vessels by a pipe. What do you expect? From where this water flow? Water will flow from vessel A to vessel B. Let's create a different condition, because level of water, water contained in vessel A is more. So level is higher, energy here is higher than in a water level energy in B. Let's do same exercise. I'm doing it but slightly in different manner. Now I keep vessel B at table, at some table, right? This is a table where vessel B is kept. And we will keep another vessel which is a larger in size, containing more water in it in comparison to B. And now you connect these two vessels with the pipe. Then water begins to flow from B to A. Why does water flow now from B to A? Because you have kept vessel B on the top of the table. And once you keep this vessel B at the top of the table, the level of potential energy of the water field in the vessel B becomes more than the vessel A. So it begins to flow. You never have seen that energy is ever flowing in nature, naturally from lower to higher value. Another example you can take: if you connect two bodies at different temperatures, energy always flows from higher temperature to lower temperature. It never flows. And how long does it flow? Unless both acquire some intermediate temperature, both acquire some same level of water. Same concept is here. Why does current flow through the positive terminal to the negative terminal? Because energy level, that is potential of point A, is higher than the potential of another point B. So in nature, it always flows from higher to lower level. That's why the convention is taken, energy flowing from positive to negative potential terminal of EMF source. Another question can come in your mind, that to make the flow of current through a conductor or through a medium, do we always need electrons? Or answer can be even no. So answer is no, it depends on the medium. Of course, in metallic conductors, there are two charge carriers, free electrons mainly, and positive ions. If we talk about electrolytes, there are positive and negative ions. For example, electrolyte means if you make a solution of sodium chloride, normal salt, then this dissociate into sodium ion and chloride ion. And if you put two electrodes, one is at higher potential, another is at lower potential, then negatively charged chlorine ion is attracted towards positive terminal. Positively charged ion sodium are attracted towards negative terminal. Likewise, water also it dissociates into H ion and OH ion, CuSO4. These all are the examples of that gets dissociated into copper and sulfate ion. Right? Copper ion and sulfate ions. Fine? If we talk about semiconductor devices, semiconducting material, semiconductors, then holes and free electrons are responsible to conduct electric current, right? So even you don't have any conductor to connect your electrical device like tube light, still you can glow your tube light. Practically, you can see that I do not require any charge carriers or any conducting material or wire to connect to a tube light to glow it. Even without making connection, it can glow it. Look at this picture, which shows that tube lights are glowing. Right, one end of the tube light is put in contact with the earth and another is just standing straight down to a high tension live wire. Let's see now types of the currents. There are two types of the current. Number one is direct current. It is in short is termed as DC. Sometimes people say DC current. DC current, then you can look at it will be direct current current. What is direct current? When the magnitude of current flowing through a conductor does not change with time or it remains constant, then current is termed as direct current. I repeat, when the magnitude of current does not change with time. So graph, if you plot between I and time, this will be constant parallel to time axis. So what is direct current? A current whose magnitude remains constant with time. Second is alternating current. AC, this is the current which is supplied in your homes. A current whose magnitude changes with respect to time. The simplest wave form of alternating current is shown here. It varies according to sine function. Actually, this is the waveform of current which is being supplied in your home. Let's see some symbols now to represent different devices which you use to make your electric circuit. What we are going to do? Different symbols used for making devices. To make electric circuit. Symbols of electric component or devices to design electric circuit. Design electric circuit. There are few symbols which are always used. This is positive, negative is cell. This symbol with more number of cells connected in series is battery. This is variable battery. This is number 4 is key, of course open key. Closed key. This is resistance or resistor. This is inductor. Resistance box. Ammeter is a device which you use to measure current. Voltmeter. Galvanometer. Capacitor. Variable capacitor. Rheostat, that is a variable resistance. Electric bulb. If you plot a single line, this is a connecting wire. Cross over connect, crossing over of wires. interconnected wires. These are the symbols which we use.